Hello and welcome. In this video, we will cover the basic concepts and the motivation behind autoencoders, a type of neural network used in unsupervised machine learning. Quoting Nikhil Bakuma, autoencoders are an extremely exciting new approach to unsupervised learning, and for many machine learning tasks, they have already surpassed the decades of progress made by researchers handpicking features. An autoencoder is also known as an autoassociator or a Diablo network. It's an artificial neural network that's designed to recreate the given input. They differ from restricted Boltzmann machines because they use a deterministic approach rather than a stochastic approach. An autoencoder is a type of unsupervised learning algorithm, so it will find patterns in a dataset by detecting the key features. In this example here, you can see how it would detect the key features that make up a face. Autoencoders excel in other tasks like emotion detection, image reconstruction, and dimensionality reduction. High-dimensional data is a significant problem for machine learning tasks. In fact, data scientists commonly use the phrase curse of dimensionality. Many common problems that we want to target have a large number of dimensions. Even a 256 by 256 image would have over 65,000 dimensions, one for each pixel. A high-resolution image from a smartphone would be even larger. According to a 1982 study by C.J. Stone, the time to fit a model is, at best, the function you see here. So, as we increase the dimensionality, our time to fit the model will increase exponentially. We run into additional problems when trying to reduce the dimensions. If we have a small number of dimensions, our data could overlap, resulting in a loss of data characteristics. If we have a huge number of dimensions, our data will start to get sparse, which results in an overallocation of memory. You can see how that looks in one dimension and three dimensions. Overlap and sparsity make it difficult to determine the underlying patterns, but with the proper number of dimensions, the patterns are much clearer. Take a look at the data separation outputs for the MNIST dataset of handwritten digits. The left output is from principal component analysis, or PCA, a classic algorithm for dimensionality reduction. The output on the right is from an autoencoder. We can see that it's easier to discern the data with the autoencoder's output. Here is another comparison between PCA and an autoencoder, now applied to news stories. The separability of the autoencoder is far better than PCA in this case. Since separability is important for applying clustering algorithms, this difference in quality is significant. By now, you should understand that an autoencoder can extract key image features, improve training times of other networks, and improve the separability of reduced datasets when compared to other methods. For these reasons, the autoencoder was a breakthrough in the unsupervised learning research field. Thank you for watching this video.